waiver of compound interest scheme for borrowers with loans up to rupees 2 crores, the government announced relief in the form of ex gratia payment. Now, what is ex gratia payment? It simply is the difference between the compound interest and the simple interest for the period from 1st March 2020 till 31st August 2020. This amount will be paid out to the borrower's loan account by 5th of November 2020. Ex gratia payment is taxable in the hands of the borrower as per his or her tax slab. Now, the 2 crore loan amount limit includes all the borrowings up to a total of rupees 2 crores. This scheme is only for overdues of less than 90 days and is not applicable for non-performing assets. The relief is available on all kinds of loans like housing loans, education loans, vehicle loans, MSME loans, loans for consumer durables, personal loans, credit card dues, and loans to professionals. These loans are not eligible for loans against fixed deposits, bonds, and shares. Now, how is this ex gratia amount calculated? The rate of interest that would be applicable would be the contracted rate as on Feb 29th, 2020. In case of loans where there is no interest being charged on EMI for this particular period, the interest will be applied at the MCLR or base rate for the purpose of calculation of the relief amount, that is the ex gratia amount. In case of credit cards, how is the ex gratia amount calculated? For this, the rate of interest that will be applicable will be the weighted average lending rate, or the WALR, which is generally, this is the interest rate which is charged by the card issuer for the transactions which are financed on EMI basis. Basically, for converting your transactions into EMI, there is a rate applicable, and this is the WALR. This rate will be applicable for the dues for the period from 1st March 2020 to 31st August 2020. The computation of the WALR shall be certified by the statutory auditor of the card issuer.